Next, we're going to have a look at our three inputs, then our checkbox, then our signup button, and finally, we can sign up our first user. I just want to make a quick design change to this input. I can see that our left-right padding is a little bit tight. So I have the first input for type your company's name highlighted. We've got it set as a standard input. Let's edit the style. And over on the layout tab, I just want you to add 16 pixels of left-right padding. The top and bottom padding doesn't matter because we're using a fixed height for these elements. That's much better. Another thing I'd like to do is if you just highlight these three elements at the bottom, the link, the sign up button, and the checkbox, right click, group elements in a column container. We're going to call this group actions. And then we're going to reapply some gap spacing, this time of 24 instead of 32. Actually, 20 would be better. That's much better. Okay, so I've highlighted the checkbox. And on the appearance tab, I say that I've instructed the preset status to be unchecked. That's the default. But I have checked this box here. And this reads, this checkbox should be checked. Okay. And then over on the email and password on both of these, I've also checked this input should not be empty, check. And on the password, actually we need to do that now. This input should not be empty, check. Now this is where the magic happens because we've got a button in here, okay? And if we edit the style of the button, we head over to the conditionals tab. We're going to add a new condition here. This one will say the following. So click here to define a condition. Then click the dropdown. And then we're going to say when this button isn't clickable. Isn't clickable. Then we're going to say is yes. So when this button isn't clickable is yes, then do something to the button. So we're going to disable the button when the state exists or this condition exists. Type color, font color, change this to the black, then type color again, COL, background color, and for this we're going to use our surface color. Actually, in fact, let's make it a slightly darker. Let's make it our border color. And what might be useful here is actually to set up a new color for disabled states. So let's head over to the style variables. And we have a single variable called borders. I'd like to set up a darker gray or a charcoal gray for various purposes. So we're going to create a new color variable. We're going to call this charcoal. And we're going to say body text, comma, placeholder text. And disabled text. You might think to yourself, body text and disabled text, but the context is different. The body text would be text on a white page, and the disabled text would be a charcoal color on a gray button, okay? And then create. Let's bring up the swatch, and I just want you to drag it to round about 46. Yeah, 46, 46, 46 will do. Or actually, let's bring this down slightly. There we go, 61, 61, 61. That's more charcoal. So back on the sign up button, let's head over to the appearance tab, edit the style, and let's head back to the condition. Now I want you to make the font color when this button isn't clickable is yes. Change it to this new charcoal color. So this is a really versatile color for various things. What else can we use it for? Well, we said body text. So here is some body text. The subtitle is body small, so it's body. So on the edit style, let's now change the font color to charcoal. Looking good. Heading back to the design, now we have some visual hierarchy in place. You can see that this stands out far more than this, and that's what we want. So let's first set up this sign up workflow, and then we'll come back and look at the form validation. So we're going to add a workflow on the signup button. We're going to choose account, and first one, sign the user up. Now Bubble is saying, where is the email and where is the password? And this is where we have to connect the front end and the workflow section. So I'm going to say that I named that input, I type input, it's input type your emails, and then the value of it. Let's do the same with password. Input, type your password, its value. So we're not going to require a password confirmation. This is up to you if you'd like two password fields, but these days I prefer my signup forms to be super short. But we are going to send an email to confirm the email. So I'm going to check that box. And now Bubble is saying, where is the confirmation page? And that's something we actually need to create. So we're going to come back to that in a second. The next one is remember your email, which basically means next time you land on this page, should we just pop your email back in so you don't have to type it? Again, this is up to you. Sometimes we want to let a user know or give them the option through a checkbox if they want to enable this functionality. Perhaps they're on a shared computer. We're going to leave it to no for now. And we can also collect other inputs and other data, which we will be doing in a second. But for now, let's go back to the design tab and let's preview this page again. Okay, so see what happened here. We have a grayed out or disabled state for our button set through our conditionals tab. And we have that because Bubble is smart enough to know that these inputs cannot be empty. Something needs to be in those inputs for this button to work. So let's just type in a random email here. Bubble is basically looking for an at symbol with a domain name afterwards. So I can type in gregory@gmail.com and then just a random password. And you can see that the button has become blue. Perfect. But what about these two options here? We're talking about form validation. So we've got a little bit more work to do until we allow a user to sign up. Let's head back to the editor. On this button sign up, I'm going to go across to the conditionals tab. I need to define another condition. This one will read if the checkbox, type the word check, isn't checked, okay, then let's say this element isn't clickable. Let's test that. Type a random email. And you can see we still grayed out, but let's now make a selection here. And we're back to blue. And at this stage, Bubble recognizes that the terms of service needs to be checked. So we're going to show an error color here. Now, the last thing we need to do is just make sure that a user cannot sign up without making a selection. And for that, we're going to reference the custom state. And what we're going to do here, and this is an extension of this concept of writing these conditional expressions, we can use an AND or an OR operator to basically daisy chain or connect multiple expressions together. And these multiple expressions form multiple conditions. So if I click on the word isn't checked or the words isn't checked, and this little more option comes up, let me click that. Now I've got two operators. So I want it to be AND because both the state has to be selected and the checkbox checked for this to read true. And now we're going to reference the state. Now remember when we got in the previous lesson, I mentioned that the state is set to the page. And I always do that, and that's up to me, how I design my apps. But at least I know where it is. So in this instance, I need to find it, know where it is. It's probably set at the page level or attached to the page. So I'm going to use type sign to bring up the page called signup, and there it is, custom state user type. And this is a new operator. This time I'm going to say is empty, but actually I realized we've got this checked. So we need to change from an and to an or. So let me read this out for you in plain English. When the checkbox isn't checked, or the state is empty, which is its default state, then this element isn't clickable. Okay, two conditions and then one result. Let's test this. So let's go through this process again. Okay, so we're still disabled. We're still disabled. And now we can run this workflow. So that concludes this lesson. When we come back, we're just going to finalize. We've got a few more things to do on this page because I'd then like to make a clone of this page to then look at our login page. So I'll see you in the next lesson.